There is an argument that the destruction of the withdrawing Iraqi army, in an event known as the Highway of Death, on Highways 8 and 80 out of Kuwait in the final days of the Gulf War, was illegal, because the Iraqi army was complying with UN resolutions by withdrawing from Kuwait, meaning that they could no longer be attacked. One long-time member of the Marxist-Leninist organisation Workers' World Party went so far as to call it surely one of the most heinous war crimes in contemporary history. The charge of illegality was brought back to the surface in 2018, when George H.W. Bush died, and then again in 2019, when Call of Duty made a game in which an event very similar to the Highway of Death, carried out by Russia, was used as a way to convey the fact that they are the bad guys of the game. But was Iraq complying with UN resolutions? The resolution in question is 660, which called for Iraq to immediately withdraw its army from Kuwait and begin negotiations. It was passed the same day as Iraq invaded the country on August 2, 1990. But by November, Iraq hadn't left Kuwait, and so the UN passed Resolution 678, which said that unless Iraq complied and withdrew, then UN member states were authorised to use all necessary means to enforce Resolution 660. The Soviets spent the Gulf War trying to get both sides to agree to a peaceful end to the situation, and it appeared that on February 22, 1991, they came to an agreement by which, in return for the USSR doing more to solve the Israel-Palestine conflict, and the UN calling off sanctions within 48 hours, Iraq would fully comply with Resolution 660 and leave Kuwait within 3 weeks. The US, though, were not willing to allow Iraq to get off conditionally, as they didn't trust them not to do anything similar in future if their military power were not seriously damaged, so they refused to accept. Moreover, the Iraqi offer was, by its nature, a refusal to comply with the resolution, which called for them to leave immediately and was against Resolution 661, which placed sanctions on Iraq until they withdrew. 2 days later, the coalition invaded Iraq and Kuwait. The next day, February 25th, Saddam ordered his army to withdraw back to Iraq. But he wasn't doing it to comply with the resolution. He was doing it to defend Iraqi cities. He wasn't very enthusiastic about the idea of seeing his cities occupied by coalition forces, because he left his army trying to defend Kuwait. So, as he told his advisers, it is better to withdraw the troops ourselves than have the enemy do it for us. One of his advisers advocated for a public army, arming the citizens of Iraq cities so that, if the worst came to the worst and coalition troops were rolling their tanks through Najaf and Nasiriyah, it would turn into a street war. Saddam stated that only 500 Americans needed to be killed before the US public would start calling for an end to the war. So, on the 25th, the Iraqi army was ordered to pull back towards Basra, with the Tawakkalna ala Allah Republican Guard Division tasked with holding the Americans back. This would result in the Battle of 73 Easting. Saddam considered the action not to be a retreat, but a fighting withdrawal. However, on February 26th, Baghdad Radio announced that the withdrawal was a practical compliance with UN Resolution 660. So, was Iraq actually complying? Well, it's likely that the radio broadcast was just propaganda designed to buy some time. While by this point large portions of the Iraqi army had been destroyed, Saddam refused to accept that, and still intended to carry on fighting. Proof of this is that the same day as Baghdad Radio said Iraq was complying with Resolution 660, orders were sent to corps commanders detailing the plan to defend Iraq cities. Iraqi commanders were also told to ignore an order to destroy unmovable equipment and instead bring back with them all the equipment they had, suggesting that the dictatorship felt it would need every tank, truck, and gun it could get. However, the withdrawal was a complete mess in a lot of cases, and many Iraqi commanders had no idea what was going on. On February 26th, Kuwait City was liberated. The next day, Saddam sent a message to the advanced general headquarters in Basra, telling them that, right now, the goal is to ensure the best possible safety for our fighters and their weapons, to raise their morale, and to raise their fighting spirit. This requires our defence to line up along the edge of Basra City. Their effective part should be according to the method of defending the inside of Basra. What applies to Basra will apply to the rest of the cities in Iraq, with some exceptions. It was between the 25th and the 27th that the bombings along the Highway of Death took place. So, if the argument that Iraq was complying and therefore the bombings were illegal is to be accepted, we need proof that the Iraqis intended to comply. But clearly, Saddam had no intention of doing so, except insofar as he was willing to abandon Kuwait for strategic reasons to keep on fighting. The second point of Resolution 660, that Iraq and Kuwait had to begin immediate negotiations for the resolution of their differences, certainly wasn't going to happen either. But if Iraq did fully withdraw from Kuwait, even if they did so for another reason, does that mean they technically still complied and therefore should not have been attacked during their move back to Iraq along the highways? Personally, I don't think so. Resolution 660 was not complied with. It was enforced by 500,000 coalition troops acting under Resolution 678. As such, it wouldn't be correct to call what happened on the Highway of Death illegal, because the coalition acted within the bounds of Resolution 678 to enforce Resolution 660, by which Iraq refused to abide. Because Resolution 678 was still in effect until 660 had been carried out, that meant that there was a legal justification to attack the retreating Iraqi military, as it fell under the vague wording of all necessary means, which the coalition was allowed to use because a state of conflict still existed. In other words, it was no more illegal than attacking the retreating German army in the Falaise pocket in 1944, because Germany refused to comply with the Allied demand for unconditional surrender, or the Austro-Prussian harrying of the retreating Danish army to push them out of Schleswig in 1864, following a Danish violation of the 1852 Treaty of London. The situation in 1991 was carried out with the authority of a resolution specifically made because Iraq refused to comply with the previous one. And, even when they did do what it wanted, they did not do so to comply with it, but to continue the war from a better position. So, while what happened on the Highway of Death was horrible, it was legal.